Hi friends, welcome to Cloud Pandit Online Trainings. So in this session, we are going to see how you can delete blob from the logic app. By using logic app, how you can delete the blob, we will see. So once it is completed, immediately I'm going to show you how you can delete even container from the logic app. Okay friends, to do this, we have some prerequisites friends. We need to have a blob storage. We need to create the blob storage. In the same way, once we have created the blob storage, if you want to delete any blob, if you want to delete any container inside blob, you need to have a logic app. So I am going to create a logic app. Then we are going to create containers inside blob storage. Okay. So once you have created the container inside blob storage, inside container, you are going to place your blob files. Okay. It can be your text file. It can be your image, pictures, whatever friends you are going to place inside your containers. So what I will do is first I will show you how you can delete those pictures or text files or any data which is there inside container. Later we will see how you can delete even containers friends. Okay. So next, finally, we are going to develop the workflow inside logic app. Okay. We are going to develop the workflow inside logic app to do this particular task. So how exactly our workflow will look like, you can able to see friends. I'm going to create a HTTP request. This is going to be our trigger. So once whenever I make a request to this HTTP request to this trigger is going to initiate a action. What is that action? Delete blob. What delete blob is going to do? You have to set two things friend, two steps you have to do to delete this blob. First thing is you have to create connection to blob. See, before you delete any file inside your blob container, you need to have a proper connection to the blob. Okay. Once you're connected to the blob storage, then you have to select which file you want to delete or which container you want to delete. Okay, friends. So let's quickly jump into our portal and we will see how we can create the blob storage and logic app. Okay. So I am in the portal friends. You can see I am in the portal. Let me quickly create one by one. Let's create the storage account. Click on storage accounts. Okay, click add to create the storage account friends. Okay. So as I explained, subscription is the entity which is required to access any Azure services. Resource group is basically for logical grouping friends. I will use the existing resource group. Okay, existing resource group. Let's say I just wanted to use the one which I just created, Cloud Pandit Demo RG. Okay. Then you just give your storage name. I will give my storage name is Storage Cloud Pandit L. Okay. L is basically logic app. You can say logic app. Okay. This is basically I'm doing for logic app. As this is a very big name, it is not allowing. Let's select only LP. Okay, then you can select the location friends. Let's select location as UK South or whatever you want, whatever nearest to you. Let's say for me nearest is South India. I will select standard is you will get normal performance. Premium means you will have a better disk, everything in the back end. Okay, storage V2 means you will get files, queues and tables along with the blob storage. But I don't want storage V2. Let's go with the only blob storage. Then you will be able to see local redundancy, geo redundancy, read access, geo redundancy friends. So how you want to keep your data? Okay. Where do you want to maintain your copies of data? So depends on your criticality. You have to select this option. I already made a video on this friends. You can just watch that video to understand more about replication. So access tier is basically if you want to access data very frequently, you have to select dot. Otherwise, you can select cool. Cool means you are saying I am not going to access data very frequently. Then what happens? This data will be archived and stored in the backend so that you are going to pay very less, because when it is archived, the size of the file or size of the image, size of the any binary data will reduce a lot, so that you can pay very less amount, friends. Okay. Right now, I will just put it hot. Just click review plus create, friends. Okay. Once you click review plus create. So it is just validate all the details. Once validation passed, just click create to create the storage account friends. Okay. So storage account is going to create. Meanwhile, I will just open another tab here to create our logic app friends. Just open another tab here, portal.azure.com. Okay, once you enter portal.azure.com, you will be able to sign in into the portal automatically because I already log in into portal. So it will not ask you to enter your username and password again once you log in. So here I will just search with LogicCap. Okay, click on LogicCaps to create the LogicCaps, friends. Click add to create the LogicCap. Okay, so as we just as use the resource group, this is the resource group I am using to store all my services. Okay, this is LogicCap. Just select LogicCap for Cloud Pandit. Okay, so this is fine, friends. Cloud Pandit 1 I am just taking, and if you see region, yes, in which region I am taking this LogicCap, South India. Do you want to have a log analytics? Suppose if you want to maintain what is, who is calling LogicCap, all those details, if you want to track it, all the logs. Okay, those logs, if you want to send it to the log analytics for further analysis, you can send it. Okay, right now these logs, I don't want to send it to the log analytics. Just click review, press create, friends. Okay, so validation part, just click create. So your LogicCap also is going to create in just 1 minute, friends. See, your storage is already created. Let's go to storage. Okay, you can see containers, click on containers. Let's click on container here. Let's say here I will say, you can say my data, okay? And I will give anonymous access, just click create, friends. Now your container got created, go inside container, click upload, click here to select the any file. Let's say if you want to select any images, let's say I'll just select these two images, click open, friends, and click upload. So these two images I have uploaded. Now what I wanted to do, I just want to delete this particular logicap.png inside this container. See, in which container we are? Inside my data container, we have two pictures. One is blob storage png, logicap png. So I want to delete this logicap png by using the service called logicap. Logicap also created, just click and go to resource. Then, so once you click on this LogicCap, it will take you through the designer directly, or sometimes it will take you through this home page, friends. Once you are here, just click on LogicCap designer. Then come down, you can able to see blank LogicCap because we have even multiple templates. I don't want to use these templates. I want to use a blank because I want to start from very scratch. Just click it. Here we need to create the HTTP trigger as I have shown you in the PPT. So let's create a HTTP request, friends. Search for HTTP, it will show. Okay, it will display when a HTTP request is received. Yes, okay. URL will be generated after save. Let's save it. Okay, see URL got generated. Fine, come back, click here, friends. Click on method. So we need to select the method, as I already explained the difference between get and post method. So you can watch my previous video to understand what is the difference between get and post, friends. Just select the get method. Okay, so then once we have trigger is created properly, next we have to initiate your action. What is the action you want to delete? You want to do, you want to delete the blob storage. So here just search with blob. Okay, Azure Blob Storage will come. Just click on Azure Blob Storage. You can able to see, do you want to copy blob? Do you want to create a blob? Do you want to create a blob, delete blob? All those things it will ask, friends. What we wanted to do, we want to delete the blob storage. Just select this blob storage. So then what it is doing is, it is already connected to my blob connection. One of the blob storage, it is connected, but I don't want to use the existing connection. I want to create a new connection. Click on change connection. Okay, you have two storage connections already available. These two storage connections I don't want. I want a new connection. Click add new. So now see, friends, all these storages we have. Which one we have created just now? Which one we have created just now, friends? We have created this one, LP I have used. If you remember, LogicCap, okay? LP I have used, and this here I have created, friends. So this is the storage I want to connect. Select this and give the name of your connection. Let's say my demo connection, or you can say my blob connection, friends. My blob connection. Okay, then click create. Okay, so your connection established, friends. If you expand it here, if you check it here, see my data folder we have created. Go inside, you can able to see two files, two pictures, blob storage and logicap. So which one we wanted to delete? So I want to delete logicap.png. This is the picture I want to delete. Okay, just do it that, friends. Okay, now what you can do is, you can see, friends, blob storage, you just selected logicap.png and you have created the trigger, you have created the action. Now save everything. Once you save, go back to blob storage and refresh and check. We have two pictures now. Come back here. Now I want to run my logicap. Click on run, friends. So you can make this call from the Azure Data Factory and other services as well, friends. Okay, for now we will test it here. So what it has done, it has successfully deleted. Let's go back here, refresh it. See, your picture got deleted, logicap.png got deleted successfully, friends. Okay, so now what if you expand this, you will come to know what exactly has happened. So you can see here, friends, 200 means success message, friends. Successfully it has deleted logicap.png picture under my data container. Okay, let's say this is how we have deleted our blob picture. Okay, so I want to delete entire container itself, my data container itself. I want to delete. How you can do that? Go back to your designer, click on this delete blob. Now just remove this logicap. Don't select any picture, friends. Don't select any picture. Okay, click here. Save it. Now what you have selected here, you have selected only your container name. Now just make sure that your container is available currently. So refresh it. So it is available, friends. Now come back, run your logicap. So it will just take some 10 seconds to execute it, friends. So our delete blob got failed. Why it got failed? Let's check. Okay, what it is saying, friends? Blob name is null or empty. Okay, why it is saying blob name is null or empty? Very simple, friends. Go back to your designer, I will tell you. Click here. See, just click here, friends. Then just select it. This one. Okay, just select it. After that, what you need to do is don't give these slashes and all, friends. Just to remove all these slashes as well. Just let me remove all these things. One second. Just select, click save, friends. So you just select your content, just put your container name here. Now make sure that it is available again. It is available. Come back, click run, friends. Let's wait for about 10 seconds. Your logicap is going to execute it, friends. Now if you see, friends, your logicap got executed. Now if you go back here, click refresh, you will be able to see this container got deleted, friends. Your container got deleted. So this is how you can delete your blob files, or you can even delete your containers as well. Okay, friends, thank you all. If you have any doubts, you can comment in the comment section, friends. Thank you all.